Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And today, fellas, I was digging into the replays which I had and still have on my desktop, and I managed to find a couple of battles when I played with IS-7. So the first battle is going to be quite good game in my opinion. We did everything properly and I'm very, very happy with the score. And the second battle, you are going to see like a half game, because in the first half I was lurking in front and back, blah blah blah, but the end game situation is going to be quite interesting, so stay tuned for that. And the first things first, what do we have here? We have Karelia North spawn, and the situation here is not looking super good because there is 3 clickers in each team, unfortunately, and it is not looking good at all, okay? So what I decided to do right here, I decided to cross to the Alpha 3, so I'm going to be kind of Arta safe, right? Unless the Conqueror Gun Carrier will decide to drop the load on me, but I hope it's not going to be the case and I'm just piri heading over there. Why I'm not pushing too aggressively here? Because I have speed and so on. If I would sit over there, Artas would bomb the shit out of me and I would simply forgot my name. I mean, I would get killed, you know. It's simply not worth it. It's way too risky for my playstyle, let's say like that, and I decided not to do so. So let's see what we can do right there. Currently I have quite nice position, plus on top of that, if needed, so Artas is going to boom help us. So no complaints, no regrets. We are simply waiting until the enemies will try to go in and until they will try to go aggressively. And here we go. What we managed to see there, we managed to see the 260. 260 have amazing speed. In general, their tank is very mobile and quite good. I don't have it on Rue server yet, but when I will have it, I can tell you that we will try to go on 100% of the mark of excellence. And I can promise you this, it's going to be quite hard. Don't mind my cat, okay? She, currently it is a night time and I'm recording the video, so my cat is on full mode, so everything is fine. Okay, anyways, the 1-to-1 made a pressure in front and he took one for the team. Not much what he can do right there. Mistakes were made, right? So now, right here, we are waiting until the 260 will make some kind of mistake, right? We are waiting for the angle which we could penetrate, and I am trying to be very patient right here. Too bad I did not manage to punish 262, T62A, but it's my mistake, so not much what I can do about this. Trying to craft the good angle. I am actually aiming for his cupola or maybe his cheeks. I'm still thinking because I have AP loaded right there, okay? I'm still thinking where do I want to shoot this guy, and simply being patient, waiting for his mistakes, his stupidity. Try to go for a shot, too bad that was not good one, but hey, what can I do? The 260 just shot us, but he did not manage to penetrate us. It's okay, I am feeling good. Now look, we are aiming for the cupola right there in a second. Look, beautiful shot into cupola. And beautiful, without gold, without anything, just a bit of patience and a bit of the support from the clickers. Trying to go for another cupola shot, I did not manage to hit that, so I loaded high explosive, and as you can see, he's getting killed, so we are loading APs once again. Right here we have 3v3 situation right here. Well, can I say 3v3 because our 430U is pretty much down to the one shot? I don't really think I can. The thing is, I am not going to push in front here for a reason, Artas. I am feeling completely safe right here, and maybe we can hit the E4, but our 260 is flexing on the enemies. He decided to go super aggressively, so not much what we can do. We just simply need to push together with the 260, otherwise it's going to be bad. 260 is getting clicked, E4 is feeling the same thing. So what we are going to do now, we are going on that E4, and oh boy, I see that griller in the back, okay, I see him. So our clickers is supporting supporting us quite a bit because they don't have anything to do, better idea, which is completely fine. I'm trying to track him. We managed to track the E4, and our Arthas is clicking on him. Kind of 1v3 situation. Obviously, our Arthas is helping for us, so I can't say, you know, it's fully 1v3. You get the point. Grilla full hit points, T62A, 500 hit points left. So far, so good. Enemy Arthas started to click on me, and oh boy, it's not looking that good as I expected. The T62A is saying, screw you, skill, I hate you. And Grilla stopped for a second. Ay, ay, ay. That's why you are not stopping when there is three Arthas. Although I'm getting banged by the clickers too, but you know what? They can, at least they cannot penetrate me. And Grilla got penetrated, so, you know, he's down to the one shot. So now, looks like cards is in my favor and I have the Joker or the Ace in my hand and I'm going to win the situation. And as you can see, it is the case. Solid 3,700 damage right here and 3,500 assisting slash tracking damage, right? So far so good. So what I can do now in this kind of situation, there is two options. Option number one, I can go for base death. Option number two is I can keep pushing for enemy Arthas. Obviously, I'm not going for Arthas because I will get spotted by someone and then boots, and this is going to be end of the story. So I'm not that brave. I would rather defend the base. And if you paid attention at the maximap, looks like we have AFK 277. At least he did not move it from the very first minute of the battle, and now already 6 minutes passed away. So probably he's AFK, I just guess. Anyways, and what we are doing right... Ooh, fellas, 277 is back to life. So we have our 277 back. So situation is looking way better immediately, just like this. Very nice. So first things, what we are going to do, we are going to take this position over there just because we have a crossfire on the 430U. And if he will decide to go a bit more aggressive over there, more likely we can smack him. Obviously, that makes sense, right? So simply being a bit patient until the 430U is going to get spotted. Right there, he's spotted. Immediately when I notice that, I am moving in front because I need to help our team. Otherwise, it's going to be bad. Meanwhile, the Death Star is going down and he's not in the sky anymore. Feels bad, man. Okay, don't worry, fellas. It is okay. We still can do this. As you can see, our 277 have shit ton of health, and we have 3 clickers right here, which can actually support us, and in the same time, we can try to craft the angle. And as you can see, we have the angle on the 705A. I am thinking, do I want to shoot or don't? I don't want to shoot, and as you can see, I lost my angle. Right here, I went for semi-snapshot, which did not work too well in my favor, but hey, what can you do? Not much. So patience, fellas, patience. This is very, very, very important. And we crafted the side shot for the 705A. Meanwhile, the 277 is holding him. Our Arthas is clicking, enemy Arthas is clicking, and everyone is getting clicked in the left, in the right, in the right, in the left. Our 277 still have 700 hit points left right there, and he's going for a killing shot for 705. So what kind of information do we have and what is happening right here? By the way, one of our Arthas relocated here, which is quite nice. So enemies have 3 clickers, 2 tank destroyers, 3 clickers, 1 tank destroyer. Jack Peace the last time was spotted here. Also Arthas, as you can see, relocated, and Budget Arta made a loop like this. So what happened? He obviously managed to spot us, but hey, we got the shot into the Budget, and oh boy, Jack Peace the relocated. So Jack Peace the, instead of being over there and he was spotted here last time, he went all the way through like this. So now imagine, if I would push in front like this, I would meet Jack Peace the and Arthas would fap on me. So that was definitely a good decision right there, just to go, let's say like that, for a base defense and then repushing this side, right? Because it's working for sure. So what we are doing here, we have a shot on Jack Peace the because our Arthas spotted that. And you know what? I made a mistake. I shouldn't shoot this time. I needed to wait until Jack Peace the will turn fully, then I needed to shoot. But hey, what can you do? Not much. And right now we rigged Brethren Arms already with a batch at Art over there, which is always welcome and always very, very nice. We got the shot on GVE 100 and obviously he's getting clicked by our clicker. So what do we need to do now? We are thinking about going super aggressively for Jack Pizda and simply winning this game, because let's get real. Jack Pizda mobility is very, 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 very limited. It's not good mobility whatsoever. We have three artists in the game, so he is going to be permanently stunned. And it's not going to be super enjoyable thing for this guy. And also our Vitas is going down. Well, hashtag never lucky. No brother in arms for us, but hey, at least we tried. We give it a good go. Now, the same Jack Panzer, the same Jack Pizda, he have 1,200 hit points left, and I believe we can get quite some use. And as wrong as it sounds, this AFK 277 is actually helped us quite a bit to save this battle. What do I mean by saying that? Imagine, if he would go into the heavy line in the first moment of the game, he would get killed more likely, and then we would lose the base because we would not have another heavy tank to pretty much save this game. Crazy, right? How AFK tank, which was AFK for majority of the battle, can actually help you win the battle. It's insane. And I'm super happy he was actually AFK. So he actually helped us to win this game. That's very, very good. And when you think we are done, no, it's not truth. Give me a second and I will lead you into the other victory, I hope. See you soon. And fellas, we are back. As you can see, I skipped a bit of the battle in the second replay just because in those 3 minutes what happened, I went on the field, I was starting to get clicked by the artist. I said, piri piri, not today, and I simply escaped, okay? So we pretty much cutting the time a bit, so you don't need to watch this, how I'm taking one for the team and screaming and running and saying, but we are right here exactly in time, and now we are going to enjoy the action right here. So, IS-7 in the Zikvered line. We need to defend our base, and oh boy, we will try to do everything what we can. Right here, as you can see, the E100 pushed a bit more in front here, and he is taking one for the team from us and from our 705A, and I'm flexing on him. You know what? Karma is a bitch. Have you ever heard this saying? I can prove you this. Side shot into the IS-7 and Arta. So, you know, I shouldn't flex against this E100. I deserve this. I'm accepting my responsibility. So, right now I notice that I am not safe for the artist, so it's not very good thing. I kind of need to move, I am a bit afraid, but in the same time I just need to do this, otherwise it's going to be bad. So we are going together close to that 705A, and hopefully we will not get punished in the middle of the way. And as you can see, it is the case. We are crossing. Grilla got spotted, Grilla got smacked, and now I simply need to go a bit more in front right here, so hopefully we can craft some use. 5 minutes passed of this game already, and once again you did not saw the start because it was nothing good happened right here, and I am trying to save a bit of your time, fellas. And this battle will have epic moments. You don't believe in me? Wait. You are going to see the triple way sandwich. Have you ever seen that? No? Good. It's time to chill and to wait a bit. So, as you can see, we took the good position right here, and we was waiting till this dead star will piri piri like this. He went in front and he died. His mistake, our victory. Good. So, now, as you can see, German accuracy is looking Gucci, and Grilla did not manage to penetrate us like this, which is very, very nice. And fellas, right here, as you can see, we have the situation when we are fighting against the three Ruski heavy tanks, against the Grilla, and more likely against the Arthas. Although I did not, I can't remember did I receive any Arthas shot, so maybe I'm Arthas safe. Anyways, I believe it's fair enough. 3 Ruski tanks, 1 Grille. Grille is sniping from the back over there. Ruski tanks is in front of us, so we are trying to get as much use as we can. And I'm just trying to hit the IS-4 forehead right there instead of loading gold. Maybe it's not the best idea, by the way. Arthas actually managed to get a shot on us, so maybe the situation is a bit different here. Anyways, we managed to get the shot into the IS-7 side, which is always good, but our hero IS-7, which decided to be aggressive here, he simply took one for the team, which is not very good. But you know what, I still want to work in this side because it's working kind of fine so far. I'm not getting penetrated. I'm using my armor quite well right there. I'm not trying to side scrap because I'm afraid to expose my my shoulder or the V-shape hole side, if I can say so. So I'm just trying to find the shot. And as you can see, I managed to do that. We penetrated the IS-4. And in the same time, I have all time in the World of Tanks. So I don't see the point why would I go super aggressively for the enemies right there, right? So look. IS-4 side, I'm going for a shot, we managed to penetrate him, awesome, just awesome. And Grille managed to find shot on us too, because he loaded hit, which is completely fine. I'm not complaining, I'm out of the AP ammunition either way, so I can't complain. And this, and what do you think, how everything is looking now? Let's cap everything out here. So, the situation, IS-7 piri-piri in front, IS-4 piri-piri in front, IS-7 piri-piri in front. You know when I said a three-way sandwich, what I meant? Look at this. So, enemies are playing super aggressively right here. I'm trying to build the angle that well to not get penetrated, and this is the situation of the three-way sandwich, okay? So, let's get real. When you are having this kind of situation, you know you are... You know, you are pretty much doomed, da? Da. Okay, let's see what will happen right here. So we are eliminating the first IS-7 and we are trying to build a good angle and look straight into the IS-7 so he won't be able to penetrate us, and now I need to get that killing shot or I need to get some kind of help because otherwise I'm going to be dead meat. I'm trying to find the shot into cupola and I managed to kill this IS-7. Meanwhile, I'm turning my frontal armor against the IS-4. IS-4 with he did not manage to penetrate us, and now, fellas, we are celebrating. So who is the sandwich now? This is exactly the moment why I really wanted to show you this replay. Score is not epic, okay? Okay, 4,700 damage dealt, it's fine. Assisting damage, always good. 8,500 damage blocked. That was a beautiful game, fellas. That was very, very beautiful game. And I hope you enjoyed this bit and this ending of this battle. I remember my live reaction when I was streaming this. I said, and now I'm going to get gangbanged. Or not. As you can see, no one knows how the games is going to end. Obviously, they was not best players in the World of Tanks. They was maybe panicking a bit or maybe using auto-aim, which is not the best idea in World of Tanks because you need to aim for those weak spots. Otherwise, it's not going to be good. Anyways, I hope I made your day just a bit better. I hope you enjoyed this replay and this sandwich. Thank you so much for watching, fellas. See you next time. Peace.